Students, today we are going to see how to do a BB program to validate username and password from the database and display an appropriate message. And this we are going to do using ADODB. Right? So first I'm going to enter Microsoft Visual Basic. And I'm choosing a standard exe for project. Open. The project is now open. So the first step here is, do we have a database first? At the moment, we are working with Microsoft Access. So we need to create a database wherein we have the username and the password stored. To create the database, go to Add-ins. Add-ins, Visual Data Manager. So here, go File. If you already have a database, open the database. If you don't have a database, create a new database. So new, and what database are you going to create? Microsoft Access, and what will be the version? Version will be 7. So it is, I'm just again going to go again. File, New, Microsoft Access, version 7 MDB. When I click this, it tells me, it asks me for the name of the database. So I'm going to give here 4th SEM BCA, and I am saving it. Please note the directory you're saving your database. I am saving it in My Documents, and here I am saving it in My Documents. Please note down the path where you are storing your database. I am storing it in My Documents. Save. So now I've got the database. Time to create the table in the database. Now in the database window, click Properties and right click the property. You have a menu called New Table. The pop-up menu, you have a menu bar called New Table. Click that and let the table name be Login. The table name is Login. I'm going to add two fields there. So let me add the first field. Add field. It is going to be the user name. And then it's going to be text. Username is generally going to be text, and size is 50. Okay. And the next column, or the next field I'm going to add, is password. So now again, it's a text, size 50. I say okay. And then I don't require any more fields. I say close. Right? I have just created the database. Fields, not the table is not yet ready. Until you go here and click on build table. You click on the build table. So now the table is ready. The login table is ready. I'm going to enter the values here itself. I'm not going to enter the values from VB, but I'm going to enter the values here. I'm just going to retrieve and check things using Visual Basic. So here I double click login. I'm going to double click login. I have a small form visible here. Click add. Click add. Right? I'm going to give the username. Let that be Punit. And let the password be BCA. Right? I'm going to update that. I'm going to add one more username. Let that be G1, and then I'll just give the password to be BCA It's done. So name is given, password is busy update. So what it was, I click add. I got a form wherein I had the update and cancel, wherein I entered and I updated. So I entered two records here. As of now, there are two records here. One is Puneet, the other one is Jeevan. Right? So I've got two records here. So now I'm done with my database creation as well as entering the data into the database. The next step is what we are going to do is always, we are going to follow always three steps with respect to Visual Basic. Design the form, name the components, change the properties, add the events and code. So we are going to design the form. So to design the form, I need two text boxes to get the I need two text boxes to get the username and the password. So it's text one and text two. And labels describe what is to be entered in the text box. So here I'm going to have the caption, username, and then here I have password, right? And then I need two buttons, login and cancel. So I'll have login and this is cancel. So here, normally to connect with the database, we use ADO DC or this data or the concept of ADO DC is also implemented using ADO DB. So in that case, to use ADO DB is nothing but programmatically doing the work of addition, deletion and updation of a database rather than using the ActiveX control ADO DC. So to enable the working of ADO DB, go to project, go to references, project references, and here please go and select Microsoft ActiveX Data Control. ActiveX Data Objects 2 library. Can you see that? ActiveX Data Object 2 library. Click this. Right? So here, to use this, I am going to the references project. I'll come again. Cancel. I'm going to project. I'm going to references. And in here, I'm going to Microsoft ActiveX Data Object 2 library. I am checking that on and I'm saying OK. So the preliminary for all these things is ready. It is done and ready. Now we have to go to coding. Yeah, students, now today we are going to just, this is the second part of what we have been seeing. It's a username, password, program. So here I have the project which we had done previously. I had added in project references Microsoft ActiveX data library. So now it's time to start working on the code. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create objects. So I'm saying do to do this, I go to the general declaration part. So what is general declaration basically? So when I click on to any event or procedure, the section which is on top of any event or user defined procedure or function is called the general declaration section. It is mentioned there, you can see on the top, general declaration. In the general declaration section, I am going to declare the objects. DIN, CONN, as. Because it's an object, it's always new. You should always use new. Without new, you will get an error. New, ADODB. And in this, we are going to use the connection object. I hope you remember me talking about the connection in all four objects. I was giving an example regarding the overhead tank and the taps and all those things. So this is ADODB.connection. And then DIN, RS, as new ADODB dot record set. So I've given two objects, connection and RS. This ADODB doesn't come if you don't go to project references and add ActiveX data library too. So once this is done, we need to open the connection. The connection has to be open when you load the form. So in the form load, I just go and say connection dot open. I call the open method, right? Connection dot open method takes in the following parameters. The connection string, which gives you the provider, which is Microsoft Jet Engine 4, the database which you're going to use, the username and the password, all these things. To remember the provider and everything in the connection string, it is quite difficult, right? So what am I going to do? How am I going to get the connection string? To get the connection string, go to project components, right? And choose Microsoft ADO Data Control 6, Microsoft ADO Data Control 6 OLEDB, and then say apply and say close. You will have ADODC in your toolbox. Take it and place it in your form. After doing that, right click the ADODC. You will have ADODC properties. In ADODC properties, go to the connection string part and say build. Choose the provider, which is Microsoft 4, Jet 4 OLEDB provider. Next, choose the database. The database you're going to choose is 4SEM BCA, which I have placed in my documents. If you have placed in some other folder, please choose your database. Open. Next, I'm going to do is test the connection. Test connection succeeded. Okay. Now I've got the connection string. Copy the connection string. Copy. Select the whole of the connection string and copy. Cancel. You can delete the ADODC. You don't require it any longer. I will delete the ADODC. Go to the form load. Paste your connection string. If you see in the connection string, you can see the database specified, the 4SEM BCA. You can see the provider, Microsoft Jet OLEDB 4. So I've got all the things specified. So done. Your connection is open. Time to do the next job. So next job is actually writing the code for logging. So here, go to login. So it's command one dot click. The first thing is validation. Check if the user is typing both the text boxes, the values in both the text boxes. That's the code here. If text one is empty or text two is empty, then message box, enter both username and password. You exit the program and you end if. Suppose the user types both text one and text two, then comes the next part. You have to check if the record set, is already, if rs.state is equal to 1, then if rs.state is 1, that means record set is open. I don't want to access an open record. It will say the record set is already open. So you can't open it again. So close it and then say endf. After that, you open the record source. rs.open, record set.open. So the first thing here is the source. Source is nothing but your select query. It's nothing but your select query. How do you type your select query? Normally in your DBMS, how do you type the select query? Select. So it will be like this, right? It will be select star from login where username equal to g1 and password equal to let's say it was BCA. I had just given BCA. Right, this will be the query which you will be typing. Select star from login where username is equal to g1 and password is equal to BCA. And as a result of that, it will say one record. To show you the record, it will say username, password, and it will say G1 will say BCA and will say one record retrieved or got it will say. Right? If suppose either the username or password is wrong, it will say zero record selected. This is how your database would be there. One record selected and zero record selected. So now I'm going to convert this into a string. So how do I convert this? I put a quotes here and I end the quotes here. Here it's not going to be a static name. The names are going to come dynamically as the user types in text1 and text2. So here instead of g1, I'll say ampersand text1. And then I'll concatenate the rest of the string. Remember, there is no space between this equal to and the single quote, and no space between this double quote and the single quote. And password is equal. This is again going to be a dynamic thing got from text2. So double quote here, and instead of BCA, it is ampersand text2, and again ampersand, and of course I got a single quote. Concatenate that too. So now I have changed the query here into a string which will be the source for the record sets open statement. So I copy this, I come here and I paste this. So I've got the record source or the source for the record set, and next variable is connection. On which connection am I going to use this record source? So it is CONN, and then I'm going to have the cursor type. What type of cursor? What is a cursor? Cursor is used for moving up and down, right to left, right, all those things. So the cursor type can be open dynamic. I can move from front to back to front, anywhere, first to last, that way. Add open forward only from front back, 1 to 10, not from 10 to 1. Key set, you will have a key set given, only those defined key sets can be viewed. Open static, you can't move around. So this is the cursor type which are available, and we are going to follow add open dynamic, which is we can move both up and down. Right, I've chosen the cursor type. The next is lock type. The lock type is nothing but it locks the insertion, updation and deletion. So whenever you say optimistic, it allows you insertion, updation and deletion. This can be batch or simple optimistic. The pessimistic, you don't allow insertion, updation, deletion. You can just view. That is pessimistic. And read only is nothing but one and the same. So I'm going to use add lock optimistic. I'm going to use optimistic approach. So after add lock optimistic, I say AD, CND, text. Done. So my records that I've just got. Suppose this query doesn't return any record, like as I told here. Right, as I told here, suppose it is not G1 and BCA, it is G1 and BCCA. So it is wrong, it will say 0 rows selected. If it is G1 and BCA, then it is 1 row selected. So in that case, what happens? The record set becomes empty. So it is end of file. If rs.end of file equal to true, that means no rows were selected, then the username and password is wrong. So you say message box invalid inputs. Right? And at this point, I will take text one, I'll make it as I clear the text one and text two. Else, if I have a record in the record set as a result of the resource query, that means I have got a name called G1, I have got a password called BCA. Then I say message box login successful. End of. Right? So here again, I want to view the database. So I go to Visual Data Manager. So I've got the database here. Can you see I've got two data? One is Puneet, the other one is G1. So now I've got one more code to go for the cancel. Cancel, I'll say end. So now I'm going to execute this. So execute, I'm going to say G1. BCA login successful. Right here, to just hide the password character, I've gone to the properties and set the password char property. Can you see the password char property as slash? This can also be star. So now again I execute, I type a wrong username and I type a wrong password. Say login, invalid inputs. Now I type Puneet, I say BCA, login successful. If I just change the password, I just type some password, invalid inputs. So that's your login and password program using ADO DB. Thank you.